I would consider myself a paleoanthropologist, so I study humans, but in the past. We know that fire has been around for a long time, at least a million years. Then the question is, what's been the evolving relationship that humans and human ancestors have had with fire? I spent a lot of time surveying and leading excavations in Malawi, which is in sort of southern central Africa. We thought it was going to tell us something about this particular time period where we start to see a really pretty substantial increase in the complexity with which humans, early humans, are making stone tools and just kind of making different kinds of artifacts. We knew, based on the research that had been done by our colleagues in sort of the geosciences, that there had been periods of time in the past when that lake was rising and falling, and in some points in time it was basically just gone. We were thinking, how would that have affected people on the kind of the broad scale? Our colleagues, they drilled this massive core down into the sediments of the lake. They pulled up all of this mud, and in the mud is this record of past vegetation and past fire history, because there's little bits of charcoal that end up in the system when there's more burning on the landscape. They were still busy working through the majority of their results at the same time that we started our archaeological project. We were working in parallel and sort of overlapping a bit, and it wasn't really until we had this kind of one conversation where we realized that we were both kind of coming up against the same problem. We were finding that all of the archaeological sites that we were discovering dated to a very specific time period, and that was all within the last 85,000 years. They were discovering that they were finding a lot of evidence for major ecological turnover and environmental change that they couldn't readily explain using climate variables alone. And that was also within the last 85,000 years. And so it kind of wasn't until we had a conversation with each other that we knew that we had complementary data sets that were really going to tell that story together. We think of fire often as this destructive tool. That doesn't have to be the case, because if you have the right kind of ecological knowledge and you know exactly where and when to set the fires and how to control them, what you can actually do is you can shape the landscape to do your bidding, in a sense. You can clear out undergrowth strategically, and then you can make new grass come up. And that draws in all of the animals that like to hang out in those kinds of habitats. So you can sort of engineer the world around you. What we came out with was, I think, a pretty interesting result. We were expecting the environment and the climate to have influenced the people, but really what we found is that it was people who were influencing their environments.